What got you interested in meteorology?
So I've been interested in the sky and always fascinated with things in the sky ever since I was a little kid. And I wanted to be an astronomer actually until about age 5 or 6. But when my family moved down to Virginia Beach in 1992, there's a series of really intense thunderstorms that we encountered that really got me interested in meteorology. And then I remember watching the Weather Channel day and night when Hurricane Andrew was happening at that time and just being enthralled with that coverage. And from that point on, I've been just stuck on meteorology and interested in storms and basically any type of high impact type of weather.
So now that you're here at Penn State, what research do you specialize in?
So my research area now is in dual polarization radar observations of precipitation, so all different types of storms. This can include winter storms, hail storms, severe convective storms with tornadoes and large hailstones, and then also in raindrop processes as well. And the idea is if we can use these radar observations to better understand the physical processes, that we can better treat them in models that actually end up doing the forecasts. Sure, so there's a couple of operational implications and impacts that some of our research has already had. This new network of radars around the country that the National Weather Service uses has this dual polarization technology. And so we've identified certain signatures or features of storms that can tell them something hazardous is potentially happening there. And that could be something like a precipitation transition region in the wintertime, or it could be something about hail size, it could be something about the storm is getting ready to produce a tornado. And so those forecasters can then identify these signatures in real time and have increased lead time for some of these types of hazards. And in addition, if we can improve the way we understand these physical processes and the way we represent them in numerical models, you can think about in a model it's going to be too difficult to keep track of every single raindrop or every single snowflake or hailstone. And so it's typically done to some sort of parameterization of those processes. But they need to be constrained by the observations. And so if we can improve those parameterizations using these observational constraints, then the forecasts themselves may be more accurate. And so the improving the model forecasts of things like big winter storms that obviously debilitate the northeastern region all the time in the winter, and also things like hailstones and hail size forecasts that are something we're looking at right now too. We want to understand the processes about which storms may produce just a lot of small hail that doesn't do much damage versus which storms may produce really gigantic hailstones like this that could do quite a bit of damage. And so improving those model processes and those treatments of the processes in the models, we can actually improve the forecast down the road. It's been great. I've been here almost 2 years now at Penn State, and it's a great department. We've got some fantastic students, some of the best in the country, and the faculty here are world-class researchers in a huge variety of topics. So we have a lot of breadth that I think is unique compared to a lot of other schools. We've got experts in pretty much every field, and so if I ever have a question about something, there's probably an expert right down the hall I can go talk to. And everyone's a lot of fun. It's been a really collegial environment here, and it's just a blast to work here.